I mentioned software caching as a mechanism that's available in exokernel for establishing secure binding, and software TLB is one specific example of using that software caching idea. As we know, when we have a context switch, one of the biggest sources of performance loss is the fact that you're losing locality for the newly scheduled process. And since the address space occupied by this library operating system and this library operating system are necessarily completely different, when we switch from one library operating system to another, we have to flush out the entire TLB. And if we do that, when we run this other library operating system, it's not going to find any of its virtual addresses in the TLB. And that's a huge source of overhead. And in order to mitigate that overhead, exokernel has this mechanism called software TLB. The idea is quite simple. The software TLB is sort of a snapshot of the hardware TLB for each of the operating systems. So this software TLB is a data structure in the exokernel that represents the mappings for operating system 1. Similarly, this data structure represents the mapping for library operating system number 2. So let's say currently we are running library operating system 1. So the TLB entries correspond to valid mappings for library operating systems 1. And let's say that exokernel decides to switch from this library operating system to this one. At that point, what exokernel will do is dump the TLB into the software TLB data structure it has on behalf of OS1. Actually, not all of the TLB, but we'll get to that later on. Some subset of the TLB mappings will be dumped into this data structure. And let's say that we are switching from this library operating system to this library operating system. And in that case, what exokernel is going to do is it's going to preload the TLB with the software TLB data structure that is associated with this library operating system. Essentially, what we are accomplishing is that when the library operating system starts running on the CPU, it will find some of its mappings already present in the hardware TLB. That's the idea in exokernel of having that STLB data structure associated with every library operating system to mitigate the loss of locality that happens when we do a context switch in terms of address translations. Of course, when the library operating system starts running and it does not find a mapping for a virtual address in the TLB, at that point, exokernel is going to kick up that missing virtual page translation in the TLB as a page fault up into the library operating system, and it'll get resolved exactly as we detailed earlier.